And the reason for this training basically is to be able to help us as a business to contribute our own quota to this sector. You know, this sector is a very important sector for Nigeria right now. It's obvious we need to grow our non-oil export. Last year, non-oil export did about 15%. The need to grow non-oil export is increasing by the day, but banks are unable to grow as much as give. Okay, for the sector to grow, we need to do more export. To do more export, we need more money. To get the money, we need it from the bank. And the bank must mitigate their risk. So I can understand the reason why banks drag their feet to be able to. I'm privileged to be on both sides. I've been on the side of the bank, writing product papers, financing export as a banker, and also doing the actual export and being in the trenches and face so many challenges also trying to export from Nigeria. So I understand exactly what the bank is avoiding. But the objective of this program is to contribute our own quota to understanding some of the challenges in the sector. I'll be sharing a lot of experiences and I'll be making a lot of recommendation. I'm hoping that this will probably help us to understand the sector better and be able to identify those that we can help. And you know, because if you are financing a project and there are areas that is unclear, that look like darkness, and that can be a potential source of loss. And that's exactly what we are trying to avoid. So in as much as we encourage the bank to give loan to that sector, we also know that banks have been burnt in the past. That's why we're going through this A to Z of export business financing. I'm Dele Ayimbo from 3ThinkFirst Trade Academy, for those that probably do not know me, but I know a lot of people on the platform that have joined right now. Thank you very much for being able to join. We have a number of other seminars we've been doing. We call it the post-COVID seminar series. Most of them are for exports and exporter, but bankers can join because it will help you also to learn. The one we are doing is number 7. Number 7 will be holding on Thursday, and that's partnering with Forex Hungry Importers to raise export finance, part 1. And we'll do part 2 next week. Partnering with Forex Hungry Exporter to raise financing. And we'll be doing part 2 next week. We have a WhatsApp group. We created it last week, even though after creating it, so many issues came up because of people we have worked with in the past and we had issues with their project. And they came up with so many issues, so many concerns. But like I told someone, people that called me, tried to say, don't be discouraged. I mean, just to encourage the fact that it's a good initiative, even though some people have issues. Some people have an opinion that we are not qualified to do training on it just because we've had an issue with that project. And I'm asking myself, the fact that we've done this transaction before and we've had issue is a sign that we understand the challenges and then we can educate the bank better on how to avoid those challenges. You know what has happened in the past is people find it difficult to make mistakes. People don't want to make mistakes. It's like a bank saying because it has had an issue with oil and gas, it has lost money, they will not do oil and gas again. That's not going to happen. It's for you to learn from the mistake and then correct it. Because as human beings, if a bank can make mistake in financing, is it a small business that will handle a project that cannot have issues along the line? I mean, it all depends on the perspective we all look at it from. But like I told the person that called me, it's not going to be an issue for us at all to be able to continue what we want to do. We feel if this would be a way of giving back to the society, then it makes a lot of sense. So if you are not aware of the WhatsApp group, I would drop the message on the chat box right now. That's the link you can use to join. The idea is at the end of every session, we'll be dropping the video, the link for the video on that group. And the idea is to have conversation going on that group. Someone dropped a very interesting video there today of what Ben Ayade is doing in Cross River. Those are the kind of stuff we want to see on the group. Unfortunately, we include so many bankers and a number of them left because they were not really interested in export. So that's why we decided to use links so that people can join themselves instead of adding people and then people leaving because they are not interested in what we are discussing, which is okay. I mean, it's a free word. That's very okay for us. So please, you are also free to share that link with people and friends and colleagues that might want to join that WhatsApp platform. It's strictly for discussion on export business financing. What we'll be discussing is a book I wrote about 3-4 years ago, and that book is called A to Z of Export Business Financing. And we'll be using the letter A, B, C, D to Z to discuss different issues around international trade in Nigeria. COVID is engulfing our world, creating a lot of panic and creating a lot of challenges. But what's clear about it is that it has come to change the way we know business and the way we do business. And trade as a business, a sector, is not spared from those challenges, not spared at all from those challenges. So if at all there is a concern with financing trade before, there is now more concern to finance trade. There is now more concern to finance trade because of the current challenges being faced in the world. The outlook is not looking nice, but people are still exporting and people are finding different ways of solving some of the problems. You know, we have a shipment that's supposed to go and we have to use a barge from CMS to move it into the Apapa because the first batch that left for over 2 weeks has not entered, have not gone to destination. They have to go into, spend about a week or close to 2 weeks to go into a terminal where they are now getting called up to enter inside. But the idea basically is that there are challenges, no doubt, but in the midst of that challenges, we can still factor those challenges into consideration in our financing. So I'm not discounting the challenges, no. I'm only saying it's part of the challenges we can still do the financing. Some shipments are going by air and they're doing that profitably also. In Nigeria, basically, we have agri sector, we have the manufacturing sector, and we have the mineral sector. Those are the three areas. And none of them is spared as far as COVID issue is concerned. Permit me to read this particular write-up. This is a write-up, I call it Wake Up Call, but I got it on a platform, and for every seminar I've done since last week, I've been reading this out. And the reason is because it's very important for us to know how we got to where we are right now. And the person that wrote it titled it, The Collapse of Nigerian Economy, he said the collapse of Nigeria's economy is in our hands, and why $1 is 480 naira. We shouldn't be surprised. We were far more productive in 1980 than we are today. In 1980, the key metric are as follows. We were a net exporter of refined petroleum products. Today, we import all our refined petroleum products. We ride in locally assembled cars, buses, and trucks. Pojo in Kaduna, Volkswagen in Lagos, Leyland in Ibadan, and Amco in Enugu produce our trucks, our buses, and cars. Steer in Bauchi produce agricultural tractor. And it is not just assembly. Some of these parts were produced in Nigeria. Vono Product in Lagos produce the seats for the cars. Exide in Ibadan produce the battery. Not just for Nigeria, but for the entire West Africa. Isoglass and TSG in Ibadan produce the windshield. Ferrodo in Ibadan produce the brake pad and disc. Tires produced by Dunlop in Lagos, Michelin in Port Harcourt. And I mean tire produced from rubber plantation located in River State, located in the South, located in Delta State. No rubber imported. We were listening to radio and watching TV set assembled by Sanyo in Ibadan. We were using refrigerator, freezers, and air condition produced by Thermocool. We were wearing clothes from UNTL Textile Mill in Kaduna, Chalaram in Lagos, Half Print also in Lagos, not from imported cotton, but from cotton grown in Nigeria. Our waters were running through pipe produced by Quali Pipes in Kano. Our toilets were fitted with WC produced in Kano and Abeokuta. We were cooking with LPG gas stored inside gas cylinder produced by NGC factory in Ibadan. The electricity was flowing through cables produced by Nigerian Wawa Cable, Niwil, and then Ibadan in Ibadan and Cabell Melter in Lagos and Port Harcourt. We had Butter and Leonard producing the shoes we were wearing, not from imported leather, but from leather that is tanned in Kaduna. We're mainly flying Nigeria Airways to most parts of the world. The Airways was about the biggest in Africa at that time. Most of the food were being grown. Most of the food we eat were being grown and produced in Nigeria. We were producing all of the above and more in 1980. Today, we import almost everything. There lies the source of terrible exchange rate we are experiencing today. And everybody on this platform has a critical role to play in reversing the ugly trend. And we are contributing our own quota in reversing the ugly trend by making information available free to people that care to listen and want to learn on how we can together work to reverse this trend in our country. It is not enough for us to complain about exchange rates or bring out what others are not doing or failing to do. The key question is, what are you doing? What are we producing? And what are we planning to produce? This is why three things, we have decided to contribute our own quota to the development of this nation through the free webinar program we do every week. We have one on Tuesday and the other on Thursday. The one on Thursday for exporter, the one on Tuesday for bankers. And all of them focus on export. All of them focus on export out of Nigeria. For us to grow exports, we need more finance. But those financing will be tough if we have challenges on what we need to do to be able to grow finance. If we have challenges on what we need to do to be able to grow those finance into the sector. So the objective of this program is to turn my trial into your testimony, the mess I've seen in the sector into a message for you, the experiences, both positive and negative, I have in the sector into expertise you are developing, the problem I've explained in the sector into your own promotion, and the pain of loss in the sector into your profitability. The first thing we look at today, we'll be looking at maybe two or three alphabet every week. Let's see how time permits us, actually. We have just about 1 hour. I will entertain questions. I will appreciate if, as I go ahead, you can drop your questions or your concern. It would be great if you can drop your question or concern in the chat box so that you don't forget. I would like to address them at the speed of concern. So you don't forget what you have in mind or what you think can be done. And even though I'm facilitating the session, you can vary. You are free to vary. It's a free world. We can all learn from each other. The idea for me is, can we have a platform where we discuss peculiar issues we have experienced in the sector with the hope of profiling solution? To different challenges in the sector.